These radios are not what they seem. They'll play anything you want, but they use no Bluetooth, no streaming, and just like a real radio, they're always playing, whether you're there to listen to them or not. Now, how this works is incredibly simple, but how it works is not what makes it cool. It's everything you can do with it. See, this is the result of a year-long quest, and to show you how I built them, how you can build one of your own, and why I definitely think that you should, we have to go back to June of 2024, because it all starts with this.
This is a Crosley reproduction that I saved from the trash. It worked fine, but since there was nothing particularly vintage or special about this radio, I thought I would just strip the finish, repaint it, and give it a nice spooky makeover. See, this was originally supposed to be a fun weekend project. I did not realize that when I started it, I was starting something that would take the next year of my life. I made a mock-up in Photoshop, imagining this black and silver look that would be at home in like the Addams Family or the Munsters, and I got to work on the new paint job. But as the new black and silver look started to come together, I realized that I didn't want my new gothic masterpiece to play modern radio. It looks spooky. It should sound spooky. A dark shell deserves a dark heart. My first idea was to put in a home assistant or a Bluetooth speaker, but then I'd still have to use my phone to always tell it what to play. No, I wanted the experience of radio, but playing a custom radio station. And I wanted it to be simple. No Bluetooth, no Wi-Fi, no coding. A radio station that plays only what I want and is always broadcasting, whether I'm there to listen to it or not. That's when my year-long journey really began. A journey to build a radio that's not a radio. A custom listening experience filled with spooky music, late-night broadcasts, and disembodied voices. A quest to recapture the lost magic of late-night radio. Because you see, radio is scary.
Or at least it used to be. When I was growing up, spooky radio was a huge part of my life. I remember when I was about 5 or 6, going to overnight shifts with my dad and riding my little Batman bike through the darkened halls of Atlanta radio stations like I was Danny Torrance in The Shining. I remember camping out in his old truck on summer nights and listening to gravelly-voiced truckers talk to each other over the CB radio. And the first time I ever heard Art Bell on Coast to Coast AM, from the high desert and the great, I was hooked. Scanning through the frequencies in the middle of the night, picking up half-heard broadcasts and murmurs from who knew where, there was almost something voyeuristic to it. Like maybe you weren't supposed to hear this. Maybe this wasn't meant for you. I want to try to bring back some of that old radio dark magic. Something creepy, scary, and maybe just a little bit mysterious. And the way I'm going to do that is with this and this. This is actually just a really cheap MP3 player board that I picked up off of Amazon for about $6. And it's absolutely perfect for what we need, which is kind of surprising for $6. The minute you put in the SD card or the USB drive, it just plays. And when it reaches the end of its files, it just repeats. It's fantastic. It absolutely mimics a radio broadcast. The second thing we're going to use is this, which is just a little amplifier that I picked up off of Amazon for about $9. This is what's going to get us the ability to have it be playing anytime, whether we're listening to it or not. Really, all we're doing is turning the sound on and off while the MP3 player keeps playing in the background all the time.
So now that we've figured out how to get the radio to play, we have to decide on what the radio is going to play. So I started on Spotify by making a playlist of songs that I thought would work well here. I will include a link to this playlist in the description down below in case you would like to do something similar or you just want to listen to spooky music. I get that too. Now, to get all the songs onto an SD card, I just happened to Google if I could download things from Spotify. And apparently you can, so long as you only download 100 songs at a time. Apparently Spotify is okay with this, as long as it's under 100 songs at a time. Seems fake, but okay. What I use to download from Spotify is this website here, Spotta Downloader. I'm not endorsing this website, I just did a Google search and that's what I found, and it seemed to work just fine. Your mileage may vary and I am not responsible for anything that happens from you using this. Okay? Okay. We all gotta be cool about that. But it did work for me. Once I gathered up the music, I also went to the Internet Archive and downloaded some old suspense theater. I also picked up my favorite episodes of Coast to Coast AM over the years from my own personal collection. My favorites are the Ghost to Ghost episodes from Halloween and the EVP episodes. Those are the best. I even downloaded some of my favorite episodes of podcasts like Welcome to Night Vale. Now, once I had all that together, I had to figure out a way to get them all into the correct order. That's where this comes in. I spent days making this spreadsheet, which I will also include in the description, should you happen to want it. I color-coded the whole thing. So green is music, blue is Coast to Coast AM, yellow is radio dramas, pink are just the fun interstitials that I have downloaded, like America Overnight and Pat Maine broadcasts from Alan Wake. If you know, you know. Then this purple is Night Vale episodes and other podcasts. And once I had done it once, I then did it again, which is this second column here. I did this so that instead of just having one version of the curated playlist that it loops through, it will loop through multiple curated versions of the playlist, all slightly different. So this does work really well. Time consuming is all hell, but it works. So back to the build. Now that we know what we're going to play and how we're going to play it, I think it's time we work on the radio's dial. With the actual radio mechanism figured out, I decided that I couldn't just put the old dial back into the radio. That wouldn't really look right anymore. So I decided I needed to make my own dial. I started playing with some ideas based on this old round Zenith dial that I found a picture of online. I really liked the vibe of it, but I don't know, it also felt kind of stock and standard and, well, that's just not gonna fly here. So I set about making my own version of this. And I have to say, I had so much fun designing this thing. I added so many little Easter eggs into the radio call signs around the dial. Anybody who can get all of those references without using Google, I'll be impressed. Then I decided that this bad boy needed a brand name. So without further ado, may I present the Spiracom. This bad boy now plays an unending stream of spooky music, Halloween-themed content, old Coast to Coast AM episodes, some of my favorite episodes of Welcome to Night Vale. You never know what you're going to get with this thing. I have really enjoyed the mystery of turning it on and seeing what's playing. But after I'd been living with it for a little while, I suddenly remembered, I actually have another radio. It's been sitting in a closet for quite some time.
You can put your confidence in General Electric.
This is a 1938 General Electric radio that has been in my family for as long as I can remember. And as long as I can remember, it also has never worked. This has always been something that's kind of been in the back of my mind that I wanted to do one day, to take this thing and fix it up and return it to its former glory. The problem is that I'm not an electrical engineer, and also at some point in time this thing was stripped for parts, so getting it back into working order seemed like kind of a daunting task. And even if I actually did get it back in order, at that point it would just be a radio, and I don't want to listen to modern radio on this thing. I want to turn this on and have it feel like it felt in 1938. I want to hear Bing Crosby and
I love barrels in the winter.
Bob Hope.
What do you think you're doing?
Read us asleep, Mother.
The Andrews Sisters.
Hokey-pokey bugle boy of Company B.
And Ella Fitzgerald.
Walking on down the avenue. But not a
I want this to feel like you've gone back in time every time you turn it on. With that in mind, having just finished up the Spiracom, I suddenly realized that I was in a perfect position to bring this thing back from the dead. I started off by taking out the internal components, which there are precious few of left, and giving the Bakelite housing a good scrub. It was filled with what I think Vincent Price once referred to as the funk of 40,000 years. It was pretty gross. Having given it a good soap and water bath, I started to realize that part of it was actually still kind of dull looking. I tried polishing it using some suggestions I found on the internet. Brasso polish, plastic polish, nothing really worked. I ended up finding a suggestion that perhaps the Bakelite had actually dried out, and that was causing kind of a fuzzy, hazy look to it. So I soaked it multiple times in mineral oil and let it hopefully soak that up. Whether that actually did anything, I'm not 100% sure on. If anybody knows anything about restoring Bakelite, please leave a comment. I think this could look even better than it does. But I have to admit, at the end of the day, it did come out pretty nice.
I ended up doing exactly the same thing for this that we did with the Spiracom, except I didn't bother actually programming the music. Here, a random playlist would work just fine. So I made some playlists from Spotify, downloaded them, threw them on the card, and we were good to go. I even added a nice light to the dial. That's not standard, but I thought it looked better. I think this thing turned out gorgeous. This tortoiseshell or tiger eye look to the Bakelite under the right lighting looks fantastic. And the moment I turned it on was like stepping back into the past. So now I have my spooky radio and my 40s time capsule radio. And I have to say, it has been exactly as much fun as I expected it to be getting to use these things. Just turning them on and never knowing what you're gonna hear has been an absolute blast. And I'm super excited for the holidays coming up because I'm gonna take the 40s card out of this one, pop in a card filled with vintage Christmas music, and have myself a nice little Christmas time capsule. But my favorite thing about this idea is all the possibilities. Imagine a portable boombox that only plays 80s hip hop. Imagine putting a PA speaker in your ceiling that only plays in-store music and announcements from Kmart stores in the 1980s. You could do it. I found the recordings on the Internet Archive. I'm really tempted, don't ask me why. And imagine all the video game possibilities you could make. An Alan Wake radio that plays Pat Mayne broadcasts and the old gods of Asgard. Or a Bioshock radio that feels like it was ripped right out of Rapture. Or, I'm just saying that all those components would probably fit pretty well into a Pip-Boy. But y'all ain't ready for that radio yet. Be sure to like and subscribe, it does help the channel out far more than you can possibly know. And if you are looking to make one of these yourself and would like a slightly more technical step-by-step how-to video on doing that, I will be releasing one in the next couple of days, so be sure you stick around for that and all the next projects coming up. I'll see you in the next video. It's gonna be about him. See you around.
Have you seen my baby? She's not a dame nor a lady. Not in the way she walks, the way she talks, or the way she loves me. Just look at me, I'm like a monkey in a coconut tree. You know I'm overjoyed, 'cause boy, oh boy.